Are you looking for a cheap hosting provider with great customer support? Well, in this Bluehost review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about Bluehost so you can make a better informed decision on whether Bluehost is the right hosting provider for you. I'm not going to waste your time with fluff content. Instead, I'm going to provide you value by showing you the most important results from my live tests, like the page load speed, uptime, and customer support quality. I will also show you a live demo, so you essentially get to test out Bluehost without having to actually buy it for yourself. And lastly, I'll provide you with my honest recommendations on if or who should buy Bluehost. I'll have a special bonus offer for you if you decide to pick up Bluehost through my special discounted link in the description below. I also have a free checklist on starting a successful blog for everyone. So make sure to stick with me to the end and I'll show you how to get access to this bonus. Now let's get right into this review. After purchase, setup and ease of use. You're probably wondering what Bluehost backend actually look like and would like to know how easy it is to install and manage your WordPress website, right? I'm gonna log in and show you that now. Right away, from their homepage, you can see that it looks very easy to navigate with the custom interface compared to the cPanel that most other hosting providers use. I believe navigating through the Bluehost dashboard is very simple. If you need to contact support, just click on this question mark and it'll take you to the help page. But if you need to do something technical, you can still click on advanced and it'll take you to the cPanel, which is very handy to have. Something that I don't like from Bluehost though, is if you want to create your email address, you think you'd click on email and offers, but this takes you to a paid option where they give you the option to upgrade. And I think this is very sneaky and not good business practice. Whereas you can always get a free email address by going to advanced and then type in email, click on email account, click on create and enter your username, password and click on create. And that's it. So at least you can see it's very simple to create an email address. So give them a plus for that, but a minus for hiding it. So the next thing I'll show you is how easy or hard it is to install your WordPress site. So to do this, you just click on my sites and you can add a new site here or just go here and click delete site and I'll reinstall the site for you step by step. So now we click on add site, choose your site name, choose your tagline. Now click on advanced and choose your email address, choose your username. Make sure to pick anything that's not admin because that makes it easy for hackers to get into your website. Get your password in there and now click next. Choose the domain you want to install your WordPress on. And for these free plugins, I suggest you remove them all as they can slow down your website and you may not need them. Now we click on next. And now you can see our WordPress website was successfully installed. That literally took 2 or 3 clicks. So I would say that was a very easy process. Overall, I would score Bluehost an 8 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really like that it's simple to install your WordPress site and having the option to access the cPanel to do more technical tasks is also very handy. I did take 2 marks away from them because they don't guide you well when setting up a new domain name from another provider and mislead you on things like setting up your free email address. They tend to try and upsell you a bit too much. Speed and uptime performance tests. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. The result is 1.5 seconds. This is not the fastest load speed I have tested by any means, but it's not the worst either. I think so far this speed is acceptable as I have not optimized the website yet. So there's still some potential there. So now I will take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry, if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. I'm going to first install WP Fastest Cache, which is a speed optimization plugin, and then followed by Short Pixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare. This will make it more comparable to what you would actually do in real life. After adding all the design elements and plugins to my website, it now looks like this. The speed is 3.4 seconds, which is a little too slow to be honest. Google recommends a site to load in under 3 seconds, so Bluehost missed that, but not by much. Now, I have also been monitoring the stability performance of Bluehost with Uptime Robot, and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is a perfect 100%. That's right, 0 minutes of downtime. I didn't expect it to be this good, to be honest, but data doesn't lie, so always test things out. Overall, I would rate Bluehost's speed and uptime performance a 6 out of 10. Their speed just wasn't fast enough, so I had to take a lot of points away there. Other shared hosting providers can give you speed performance almost twice as fast as Bluehost. On the positive side, they are a very reliable host, and their uptime was perfect, and I cannot fault them on that. Here's a quick question for you. Do you think Bluehost's page load speed of 3.4 seconds is faster or slower than what you expected? Let me know in the comments section below. Support. Bluehost 24/7 customer service team comes highly rated by so many people, so I will test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. 1. I will tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. 2. I will ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs, but I made sure to choose the wrong question category. 3. I asked them if they could do me a favor and install an SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. For the first question, they were willing to help straight away and scanned the website for me to check for the virus. However, they were not able to remove any virus for me if found. It would cost me $5.99 per month to add this feature. This is not ideal, but at least they can find all the virus for you, and you just have to go to the files individually and remove it yourself. For the second question, they were able to resolve my query in 10 minutes, and that includes the wait time, so I would say that's not too bad. Although their domain name renewal cost is pretty high, which I wasn't happy about. And for the last question, Bluehost did not hesitate to install my SSL certificate and Cloudflare. They immediately did that for me without having to beg them like some other hosting providers. I was impressed with that. However, the actual process did take quite a while longer than I expected. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at three different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So their three response times were 3 seconds, 1 minute and 31 seconds, and the last one was 3 seconds again. So that averages out to be around 30 seconds overall, which is definitely one of the fastest hosting providers I have tested so far. So overall, I would say their support was great, and I would score them a 7 out of 10. Their support team was friendly and willing to help to a certain extent, and they had one of the best response time even during their peak hours. They lost some points because some things were limited only to upgrades if you needed their help. Their support also took a bit too long to help with some simple tasks like helping me install my SSL certificate and Cloudflare. They had to refer me to another specialist, which I was a little disappointed as I thought this was a fairly easy task. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing you in my review so far? If yes, make sure to let me know by liking my video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content that I'll be releasing every single week. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special Bluehost discount page where you will get the best discount Bluehost is currently offering. Plus, just in a moment, I'm going to show you a neat little trick to get an even better discount than this. Now click on Get Started. I will be comparing their shared hosting plans, although Bluehost also offer other types of hosting like dedicated hosting or VPS hosting, so they can support you when your business grows and you are ready for an upgrade. There are four shared hosting plans. With the basic tier, you are limited to one website and 50 gigabytes of storage, and automatic backups is not included. The next plan is the Plus plan, which comes with the added benefit of having unlimited sites and storage. The last two plans, which is the Choice Plus and Pro plan, comes with the handy automatic backup, and the Pro lets you have the dedicated IP, which I don't think is necessary. What I think Bluehost lacks here on their two most expensive plans, the Choice Plus and the Pro plan, is the increase in speed, which most other hosting providers offer as an incentive to upgrade. So I really see no value in choosing their more expensive plans here, as you really only get the advantage of the site backup, which can be done with free plugins anyway. That being said, in terms of pricing, I would only buy the basic plan if you only need one website. But if you require multiple websites, then the Plus plan is enough for you. Don't waste money on their more expensive plans. So now I will choose their basic plan for this tutorial to test them out. Now, I have a problem with the domain names these hosting providers charge you. Other YouTubers won't tell you this and it really annoys me, so I'm going to be honest and break this down for you. I really don't suggest you buy your domain name from any hosting provider, as they usually charge you much higher than a dedicated domain name provider. Right now for Bluehost, even though the domain name and domain privacy is free for the first year, every year after that, you will have to pay $17.99 for domain name renewal and $14.88 for domain privacy renewal. This total is going to be $32.87 every single year, and I think that's ridiculous. Bluehost is not the only one guilty of this. All web hosting providers do this to you. So what I recommend you do instead is to buy all your domain names from Namecheap.com. And you can get your domain name for under $8.88 with domain privacy included for free. And it will only cost you $12.98 to renew each year, which is almost three times cheaper than Bluehost. So that is a no-brainer for me. Plus, you get to have all your domains hosted in one place, which makes it very convenient when you ever want to do anything to them. Now, if you need help with getting your domain name from Namecheap, then you can check out this video here where I guide you through the process step by step. So I just put in my domain name and click next. Now you just need to fill out your personal information and come down to the more important part here. Bluehost comes with 12, 24, and 36 month payment plans. Obviously, the longer the deal, the cheaper it gets. Generally, I would always suggest you to buy the 36 month plan as you get the cheapest price and you will have no reason to leave once you have picked a great hosting provider that you are happy with. But if you're not, then Bluehost has a 30-day money-back guarantee so you can get a full refund. I also want to let you know, if you get this free domain name from Bluehost, they will still charge you for that part as the domain name cannot be refunded. So just be careful with that. Now I will show you a quick little discount trick that people don't tell you about. What you need to do is move your mouse all the way out of the screen. So if I move it to the top, then this special sign up offer will appear. And right now you can get Bluehost for as low as $2.65 per month. So I'm going to click claim savings. And if we go down, you can see that my price has changed to $2.65 per month. And the rest of these, you definitely don't need. And what you do is go to the bottom, fill out your payment information, agree with their terms, and click on submit. The overall pricing score I would give Bluehost is a 9 out of 10. I took one mark off as their more expensive plans don't offer enough value to be worth the money. On the other hand, their low tier options are very cheap when you use my little trick, and it is comparable to other cheaper hosting providers, so I would say they are a really cost-effective hosting provider overall. This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Bluehost through my link, then just send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you access to my bonus course right away. It's that easy. And if you want my free checklist on starting a successful blog, then just go to this link in the description to get access to that. Recommendation. Overall, I have given Bluehost an average score of 7 out of 10. They are a solid hosting provider. They have cheap hosting plans. The user interface is clean and easy to navigate, and their support team is better than average. So this is my recommendation for you. Whether you're a beginner or advanced user looking for a cheap hosting provider with a customized user interface and are not so worried about performance, then I believe Bluehost is worth considering. However, if speed performance really matters to you, then I don't think Bluehost is the right option for you here. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step for your business, so you must get this right. And if after watching this review, you think Bluehost is not the right hosting provider for you, then I recommend you check out this web hosting alternative, which I know will do the job for you. But if you're happy with Bluehost, then go to this next video, and I'll see you over in the next tutorial.